some new shit day. Your Valentine. What? Uh-huh. Look, Judge. Yeah. Send this one out to all the ladies that got beef with another bitch. Uh-huh. Just walk to that bitch and tell her what you're telling. Hoes, all my hoes, come on in, all my hoes, come on, get you a seat, D the Diva, you get you a seat, you sit your ass right there, all my hoes, come on in. Oh my god, I can't think, Cameron, Nico, I can't think of the people off the top of my head, I need to get this correct, but all my hoes, come in and you have a seat, okay? For the next 45 to 50 minutes, you will be entertained, darling, by the goddess, the queen, your gay cousin, the drag, Bimbo Winehouse, but I'm like half D, half Bimbo, half D. You know, I ain't got my chicken cutlets in, you know, just a little something. But girl, I couldn't wait to come talk to you hoes. It's been so much going. I could not wait to sit in the seat this week and just talk some shit. It's a lot of shit going on. It's a lot of shit. And I couldn't wait to come and put my little 2 cents on it. So you hoes, you get you a drink, you sit down, you lay in your bed, well, however you watch, okay? Because we must talk, hoes. We must talk. Where do we begin? She still ain't respond yet. Like, Nicki Minaj still ain't respond. Like, at first, I was saying on Facebook yesterday, this is how you do your haters. You ignore your haters. Like, you know, shout out to all the gay people. This is how you ignore the homophobes, okay? You just ignore, you give them the silent treatment. Do not say nothing. I try to tell you, or silence hurts a person more than any words. And then someone put me in my place because I was wrong. They said, bitch, shut up. This is hip hop. This is rap. Ain't no silence. You throw a shot at me, I'm going to throw a shot at you. You best throw this side. Hip. Right. You right. I'm sorry. Yes, this is hip hop, okay? If someone come after you, you go after them, and then you know whoever wins, but you don't throw shots, and then when someone throws a bigger shot back at you, you just completely ignore. Like, Nicki, if you was going to ignore Remy, you were supposed to not say nothing from the start. Once that song came out, the Remy diss, the first one, because she put out another one, but you was supposed to say nothing. You was not supposed to talk about album sales. You was not supposed to put up that video of Beyonce talking about, I met a girl named Nicki and she's the queen of... You wasn't supposed to... If you wasn't going to say nothing, you wasn't supposed to say nothing. But the fact that you put that up, you acknowledged it. You know what I mean? And then everyone started to say, if you're going to respond, honey, you can't talk about album sales, okay? So what else you going... What else do you have to... What else can Nicki say about Remy? What? So, looky here, bitch. Shout out to rapper Foxy Brown, who I heard just had a baby, allegedly, by reggae artist Spraga Benz, allegedly, alright? Because, you know, at this point, Foxy, you know, she's trying to stay relevant, so she gonna say and do anything to keep the name buzzing. So let me see that baby. I need to see pictures of that baby, Foxy. Let me know this is your baby, honey. Do you really have a baby? Brittany, can you respond back to me? Let me know. Is this like real? Did Foxy really give birth? Anyway, Foxy just released a diss track against Remy Ma. The plot thickens now. Okay, now Foxy is in the ring now. So you got Nicki, Remy, and Foxy in the ring. Like, and the track is called "The Break's Over." She rapped over Jay-Z's "The Takeover." Like when Nas and Jay was beefing. Nas went hard. Like, his the Ether song was better than the Jay-Z's, but the beat, Jay-Z's Takeover beat was hard. So, alright, so Foxy put out a snippet. It's not really a full song, because you know Foxy is the queen of snippets. We done had about 50 snippets from Foxy, and the songs never were released. So hopefully this song gets released tonight. You want to hear it? You want to hear it, Sister Patterson? Well, keep watching, ho. Some of you all probably heard it. And then Foxy was trending on Twitter. And you black Twitter, you people so mean. You're just mean, bitch. Someone said Foxy Brown is trending on Twitter. What year is this? 1996. Yo, I can't. They said you all are mean. Just mean for no reason. Okay? So, we're going to listen to the Foxy Brown track later. If you haven't heard it. I was like, I was happy at first, you know, I was like, and then I heard the track about 20 times. I was like, really, Foxy, this is the best you can do. But I'm gonna let you all listen, you all could be the judge, ho. Also, did you see that Trey Songz sex tape? Yes, there's a sex tape of Trey Songz fucking somebody in the ass. I don't know if it's a man or a woman. He's like, oh, give me that ass. Oh, so let's talk about that. And speaking of sex, hot, smelly sex, you all, I posted on Wednesday or Thursday, you know, I did something with this dude. You all, I think I had sex with a retard. Yes, one of them, 1, 2, 3, 4, one of them, yes, y'all, I think I had sex with a, I'm not trying to make a joke of it, but I think a retard fucked me. He would never get this ass again, but dare I said it, I actually enjoyed it. But So we're gonna talk about that. And then also I have an email from Trina. She needs advice. The best way to get over a breakup. So Trina, if you're watching, gal, I will try to help you. Okay, for someone who don't do relationships, I mean, I can give you advice on, you know, how to get over a relationship. I try to tell you dumb people don't be in these relationships anyway. So we got a lot to talk about, y'all. Yes, Miss Dang, we got a lot to talk about. And I'm so happy that I'm here today to entertain you guys. So we're going to go into the intro. When we come back, we're going to start the motherfucking show. It's the Bimbo Winehouse Addiction Show. Let's go.
Oh shit, here we go, oh shit, yes, you better dip it low, oh shit, ow, I'm on the dance floor, I don't give a fuck, I'ma take that dick and take it out my butt, I got a juicy ass and a big ass cock, y'all know this weight, I just won't stop, I'm not covering, but I get super head, I'ma choke on that dick until I'm dead, I'm a nasty hoe, I'm a freak bitch, come on me boys, y'all watching that addiction shit, ow, yes, dip it low, and break it up slow.
I have a question. Have you donated to the show yet? A lot of you hoes talking about Bimbo, create a GoFundMe. Half you hoes ain't donate yet. So all you hoes who ain't donate, bitch, donate. I know you got your taxes. Donate a little something to the show. A little $20, a little $30. Donate. Thank you in advance. However, I would like to thank everyone who have donated thus far on my GoFundMe. I would like to shout out to Debbie Burris. I hope I pronounce you guys' names right. You all know I have a third grade education. 1, 2, 3. Third grade, yeah. So if I don't pronounce your name right, you know, blaming all the education. So shout out to Debbie Burris. She donated twice. I think in total you donated like almost $40. So thank you, Deb. Thank you so much, hon. Also, I want to shout out to Marquise Butler, who has donated $10. Thank you, Marquise. Michelle Williams from Destiny's Child. Hey, Michelle, say my name. Say my... No, I don't know if this is the real... If it is, Michelle Weems, thank you from Destiny's Child, girl. Thank you. You watched the Scorpion show. You might as well watch this. Much more entertaining, girl. Also, shout out to the Diva Wilson, darling. I love you. I wish I could get... She donated the biggest donation thus far. Not that the amount matters, but bitch, you do. $50. Thank you, D, for donating $50 to the show, darling. I hope you enjoyed your trip down to... D, where you went? To North Carolina? South? You went to one of the Carolinas. I hope you enjoyed your trip a little. Sometimes we need to get away from Mount Vernon. Just once in a blow. So thank you, D, for your donation of $50. Veronica Robinson, thank you for your donation of $15. And anonymous people who donated. Somebody donated $40, whoever you are, thank you. Who donated $40? You don't want to tell me who you are. What are you, Dan Lowman? Let me give you a little nibble action, honey. All right. So, did I say my greeting? No, I didn't. What's up, hoes? What's up, all the down low gay men? All the haters, all the supporters. Two snaps for y'all. It's Bimbo Winehouse, and you're checking out the Bimbo Winehouse show with my co-host, Sister Patterson. Look like you going to the gym, girl. Mm-hmm. But again, thank you to everyone who's donated so far. If you would like to donate, the GoFundMe link is below. And bitch, I already got my coins, honey. Yes, I did. As soon as I seen the first donation, bloop, straight to my account, darling. Thank you. So, but no, if you want to donate, the GoFund is below, bitch. $20 is not that. It's not that. It won't kill your pockets, bitch. Okay? Thank you in advance, guys. So, how was everybody week? What you do? What did you do this week, darling? Me? You know, the usual. The usual. I'll tell you about the in a second. But, yo, I'm going to hell. I'm going to hell. I am going to, bitch, we all going to hell. But I'm going to hell. But he was I was like, oh, what is going on back there? But it was good. I'll tell you about it in a second. All right, so besides that, I went to the movies. I met up with one of my old high school friends. Well, a little after high school. How you look at me, high school? Yes, I graduated from high school. Third grade education. I joke with y'all, but after third grade, I was like still in school, but I was just out of it. Like, I was there, but I was not really there, so I wasn't learning nothing. I don't know how the hell I made it through. So I graduated, bitch. But my high school friend, Tanifa, I posted the picture on Facebook. Yeah, me and her here, we went to go see that movie, Get Out. Get Out. Get Out. With the black guy dating a white girl. You all need to go see it. Yeah, so we went last Sunday, and I had such a good time. Me and Tanifa, we've been friends for almost 10, 15 years. And it's nothing like being friends with someone and you two haven't talked in so long, and then you can just pick up the phone and say, hey. She like, hey. I'm like, what you doing today? She like, no, let's go to the movies. We just came and got me and we hung out, and it was just like, oh, I'm start crying. I'm gonna start crying. Because I don't have many friends. I don't. Oh, I'm sorry. I don't have many friends, so I don't. Oh, I'm crying. So I cherish the few people that I can just be my I'm real, but I can just be my authentic self around them. Like, I love Tanifa. I can talk to her about it. It's so weird because she's like a girl. She's like, she's into, she like white boys, Puerto Rican boy. She's like one of them sophisticated, look at me again, you know, one of them bougie types. And so when I come, it's just like a hot mess, and it's just like, I love her. I hugged her, we hugged, and she was like, Bimbo, bitch. I was like, I said, we're doing this more often. So we're gonna go on a trip, we're planning, we're gonna do more stuff. Like, you need to be around people that you can just, oh, I'm a mess, so I can't be around another mess. I need someone to tame me, you know what I mean? So, I had such a good time. I had nachos, we sneaked our sodas in, she had popcorn. I had such a good time last Sunday. I really appreciate Tanifa. I don't know if you. I love you. I love you. I love you. I love you. My best. Like I love. I don't want to say my. I don't like using the word bestie, but I love her. So all I'm saying is, cherish the few people that, because there's some fucked up people in this world. So cherish the few ones that you still like. I only have like 3-4 people. I got my Tanifa, Dana. I don't really have that many people. People I can really just bug out with. Like, you know, D. I mean, y'all, you know what I'm saying. Anyway, go see the movie Get Out. Like I said, it's with the white girl and the black guy. It's a twist at the end. And I kept telling Tanifa, that's why I like going to the movies with people, because I know already what's going to happen. Everything I told her was going to happen, happened. Like, it just, you got to watch movies. That's why I like to watch movies from the very beginning. Because from the beginning, you learn a lot. I hate walking into a movie theater 10 minutes late and I've missed the beginning. I don't want to watch the movie no more. I need to see it. I need to see the attractions, everything. Alright, when they tell you, when the people talk, like, welcome to the movies, your two exes are in front of you, and turn off your cell phones. I need to see all that. So, all I say is, like, I had a good time with Tanifa. Tanifa, I love you, and we're going to do it again. I'm thinking about going to a spa with her. Maybe we go to the spa one day, because I've never been to a spa. And I can go with her. Her or my friend Nasheen, who I also reconnected with last week. Like, it just, reunited, and it feels so good. Anyway, did you all see the movie Get Out? What did you think about it? I was falling asleep at a few parts. Some of the scenes were like a little too long. I'm like, all right, can we get to the action, please? But it got to the, it was a pretty good movie. So anyway, so that was my week. You know what I hate? You know what I hate? When I'm on these sites, Plenty of Fish or Tag, you know, whatever sites I put my drag queen pictures on, and I'm talking to a sexy dude from another city or another state, and, you know, I ask him, you know, do you drive? You know, what's good? I'm trying to see you. And he tells me yes. Yeah, and I get all happy thinking, yes, he drives, he about to come see me. And then the next message is, my license is suspended. Or, I don't have a car, or my car's in the shop, or I'm not, then you don't drive, stupid. I can't, you know how many dudes do that? Yes, I have my license. If you physically do not have a car that you can get in right now and drive to me in Mount Vernon, you don't drive mine, okay? The dude I'm talking to yesterday talked about, well, he was talking for a minute, and it was time for us to meet. It was like 2:00 in the morning. So I was like, so you about to get in your car and come see me? He was like, oh, I don't have my car right now. So all this time I'm wasting with you, thinking you about to come over here and drive to see me. You don't even have a damn car. If you don't have a car, your license don't matter. I'm sorry. Don't. You need to physically have a car that you can get in, and I hate that. So I asked dude, I don't even ask, do you drive? No. I say, do you have a car? Do you have a car that you can get in right now and come see me? Some of these dudes do be having cars. Like the one I have from New Rochelle, he was hot. I need to see him again, baby. And you know what else I hate? When you ask a person where they're from, like, where are you from? And then the dudes, he'd be like, you know, I'm from Queens, or I'm from the Bronx, or I'm from Yonkers, or I'm from wherever they say they from. And you be all happy thinking they close to you. And then they say, oh, right now I'm living in Africa. The fuck you living in Africa for? You gonna tell me. When a person asks you where you from, it means where are you at right now, okay? Don't tell me that you from Queens, but you living in Europe or somewhere. Like, if I just get so annoyed. It's little things like that that just irks me, okay? You need to tell people, you should not have the Bronx, New York on your location. Your location is not Bronx, New York. You are living in South Carolina, boo-boo, okay? I was talking to another dude. He was so freaking cute. I forget the site it was on, but his location, I think, said Harlem. So, you know, I mean, it's a little ways for me, but it's still, I can still go to Harlem, like 10 minutes on the Metro North. So, we were supposed to meet. He's like, oh, I'll be back in New York in July. The fuck you telling me you're going to be back in New York in July? What is that going to do for me? What is that? Bitch, I could be dead by July. Them are just two questions I'd ask now. Do you have a car that you can get in and drive me? And where do you live right now? I don't care where you from. It don't matter where you from. It's where you at. The past don't matter. Yes, we all think the past don't matter, bitch. It's what's going on right now. Okay? I don't care about the future. I don't care about the past. What's happening right now? So, you all need to ask these motherfuckers, where are they from right now? I just get so fucking irritated, Sister Patterson. That's why I rather just walk outside and just mess with any John Doe, honey. Because he's right there, bitch. I'm sorry. I just get so irritated on these social media sites. Like, you're better off just going outside meeting somebody, because when you meet them outside, you can see exactly what they look like, you know, because people be having all these pictures on their Instagram and all these social media websites and looking all, you know, and then you meet them in person, you be like, who is this? Okay, because this is not true. So your best bet is just to go out and meet somebody, because I'm getting tired of social media. Like, I'm really in trying to meet people, because it's like, what is up with all these questions, bitch? Just come fuck me in my ass. Like, I don't need all these million questions, and, you know, just come do what I gotta do, baby. Does that bother you? I'm being a little too bitchy, but I'm sorry, like, whatever. Whatever. And speaking of hoeing, I've been a hoe all week. I don't know what's been going on with me, but, bitch, I've been back to hoeing. I took a little break for a couple of weeks, months. But bitch, I'm back to hoeing. That song by Lil Kim and Lil C's and Crush On You, and you hear Biggie Smalls, he's a slut, he's a hoe, he's a freak, got a different girl every day of the week. Oh, bitch, that's warm, okay? So, I'm gonna tell you about two dudes. I'll tell you about the in a second. But the other day I was walking up, because it's been nice in New York City, like these past few weeks. It's been nice. I don't know where the winter is at. I mean, it's here tonight because I'm cold. But winter, wherever you at, bitch, you stay there. We don't want you. We don't like you. Shout out to you meatballs out there who like the winter. You are a retard. The fuck you like the cold weather for? I hate the cold weather. But it's been a little nice. So, I went out on Wednesday or Tuesday. I don't know what day it was. It was just a night of the week. Maybe it was Tuesday. And I was walking, and this dude passed me, but he wasn't feeling me, so I was like, whatever. So I started feeling ugly, and then I'm walking, and some hotter dude walked past. Like, he was walking, I was walking this way, he was walking this way, and soon as I passed him, bitch, boom, he grabbed me and threw me against. I was like, what are you doing? He's like, give me a kiss. Bitch, I started kissing him right there, and then, oh, he grabbed my penis, I grabbed his. It was so hot. And then he was like, I was like, we in front. Because you know the download dudes, they in the hood, they like to hide and stuff. He was all up in the open. We was against some bank, between like a bank door. I was like, baby, people gonna see us. He was like, I don't give a fuck. You look so good right now. Bitch, I was so rock hard. He was like, you don't remember me? I was like, no. I don't remember. Maybe people looks changed. Because this dude, he had one of them long beards that I would look so much better. Like, I think all dudes look better with beards, but I'm a drag, so I ain't got time for no beard. I'd rather sacrifice being a drag. But he had one of them long beards. He was a little shorter than me. It was just so hot the way he did it. So he spit on his skin. He started jerking. Y'all know y'all like my old nasty story. So, bitch, I'ma tell it. Back to the raw shit, bitch. Some of you all don't like it. Fuck off. Go to the Boring Scorpion show, bitch. This is what my supporters like to hear, bitch. He spit on his skin and he started jerking my dick. I was like, oh, baby. So he's like, yo, where we gonna go? Bitch, it was a church around the corner. I'm going to hell. I don't care. It was a church around the corner. I was like, we going to that parking lot. Bitch, yes, we were inside the church parking lot. Oh, well, God know I'm a queen. God know what it is. It is dope. Oh, well, we were right in the church parking lot. Bitch, it's worse things that goes on in the church with the preacher. So don't you judge me, bitch. Them preachers be actually inside the church doing things, okay? At least I was outside the church in the parking lot. So we went inside, like, between two vans. Oh, the greatest sex I ever had. He did everything I liked. He sucked me. He kissed me. I ate his ass. I ate his ass so fucking good. He fucked me. And then, he wanted to nut. So he pulled it and he started jerking it off from my face. And he nutted. And what I also liked, he waited until I nutted. After he nutted, he's like, oh, jerk that shit. That made me even, because you know dudes after, hell, me. After I get my nut, I don't give a fuck if you get yours, bitch. You should have got yours before me. But he waited till I got mine, and I nutted, and we started kissing again, and then bitch, he farted. I was like, it's alright, baby, fart. The sex is over here. I said, damn, that was a loud fart. He's like, yo, that means your shit was good. I was like, whatever. But, that was Wednesday. I know now, that was Wednesday, because Thursday, I met with a... I met him on Thursday. So that was Wednesday with him, and yo, that was so fucking hot. Like, if you follow me on Facebook, I be posting these stories right after I do it. Like, those be real stories. Like, I posted this on Wednesday. Thursday, I did post about the retard, because he would never see me again. So, that was Wednesday. Spontaneous sex is the best. Oh, that was great. And then Thursday, the retard. Alright, so I was on Twitter. No one, for some weird reason, no one inboxes me on Twitter or on Facebook. Like, dudes trying to hook up. No one does it. I don't know if they, because I'm bimbo or whatever. No one does it. So, whatever. It is what it is. So, I got a message on Twitter, inbox, from some dude who's following me. If you want to know who it is, go to my Twitter and look at all my... I'm not telling who it is, but go look at my newest followers. And he's following a whole bunch of drag queens and trannies and shit. So, you figure it out. Oh, bitch, give me $20. I'll send you a picture. Go fund me. Yeah. I'll give you $20. I'll send you his picture, bitch. So, anyway, I was like, hey, what's up? He was like, what's good? And then I looked at his page. He's a tranny chaser or a drag queen chaser. I don't know, whatever you call them things. And I was like, whatever, it is what it is. So he's like, where you from? I'm from Mount Vernon. I told him I'm from Mount Vernon. He's from the Bronx. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Going back and forth. So we exchanged numbers. He was texting me, hitting me up. So he's like, Thursday, I want to see you. So Thursday night came. I was like, fuck it. We didn't talk. We never talked on the phone. Like, I really don't like to talk on the phone because I don't like talk like, yeah, what's up? I talk like Bruce Jenner. When I'm in drag, I talk like Caitlyn. That's one thing I love about Caitlyn. Caitlyn don't talk like no woman. Yo, this is Bruce. This is Caitlyn. What up, yo? So I tried not to talk on the phone. So anyway, Bex, let me tell you what happened. So we was meeting about 1 o'clock in the morning. He was coming from 241st, and I said, you know what? I live a little far, so I'll meet you halfway. It was nice out Thursday. So, no, this was Wednesday night, because today is Friday. This was Wednesday night. Yeah, this was Wednesday. So he calls me. So I was like, fuck, let me pick up the phone. Hello? Maya, I never talked to this dude, so I said, hello? I swear to God, you are. He was like, yo, where you at? Where you at? I was like, whoa, wait a minute, back it up, back it the fuck up. Okay, who the fuck is this? He's like, yo, I just got off the train. Yo, I tried to find you. Where you at? I said, oh, hell no, bitch. He did not sound the way he looked. If you seen his pictures, he looked like a regular hood dude. You know, this motherfucker who I was on the phone. I was like, who the fuck is this? I was like, you know what? Let me just meet him. Let me just see what it's about. So I said, look, baby, just keep walking down so-and-so block, and I'll be on the corner. He's like, all right, I'll be there about 10 minutes. I said, oh, hell to the no. But bitch, you say, you know, I made him come all the way up here, whatever, it is what it is. Not that I give a fuck, because you all know what I did to that other dude. But he didn't tell me, he just said, I'm coming up there. No, this me and this dude made plans, so I met him. So, I waiting on the corner. Y'all, he came. Sure enough, he was a retard. Like, not like a retard, but... You know he used to ride the little bus to school and was in a class with 7 students. I was like, oh no, what happened here? But he was cute. So I said, let me go see what this dude is about. So we went to another parking lot. Yes, bitch, I like to do sex outside. I don't like in the bed. In the bed is boring, okay? You need to spicing up your shit, okay? You fuck between cars. Fuck behind a dumpster or some shit. Same old in the bed sex. Boring. So we went in some parking lot. And I pulled his pants down. It was a nice average size, sister. It was nice. So I started sucking it. I'm like, oh my God. I can't believe he was like, oh, feel so good. I was like, would you shut up? Shut it up, boy, because I'm mad I'm even doing this. So, yo, I'm dead, sucked this dick. So, He was like, he was like, I wanna fuck you. I said, do you got a condom? He said, no, you have one? I said, no. So, bitch, y'all don't fuck me anyway. Bitch, he told this asshole up. He beat it up. Somebody was looking out their window too. Cause I'd seen somebody, I didn't give a fuck, whatever. So he's like, oh, about to call. Ooh. I said, you about to, he's like, he took it up my butt and nut on my butt cheeks. And I nutted, whatever. And I was like, oh my God. What did I just do here? Like, he wasn't, I mean, a little exaggerated. He wasn't like retarded, but he wasn't all the way there. It was a few screws on really, like, really tight, tighten up, you know. So, that was it. I mean, it was no really story, but he will never see me again, you all. He's been hitting me up every single day. I blocked him on Twitter. I blocked him. Somehow he found me on another site. I blocked him on that site. And then I blocked his Kick, K-I-K. I blocked him on that. But he's like, I don't change my number for nobody, but you could call me and text me too. I will not answer you. I know how you people change your number because you have a stalker, but you can call me all day. My number will remain the same. So all I do is put him under don't answer. So all day long, I'm getting texts from don't answer. Hey, baby, I want to see you. Oh, I'm going to make you wifey. I was like, oh my God, leave me the fuck alone. I don't like that was a one time deal. Never again. Even though I slightly enjoyed it. He will never get this ass again. Never, Sister Patterson. Never, never, never gonna get it. Never gonna get it. That's it. I mean, it's really not much of the story, but he was not a normal dude. Yeah, one of those. I know that, because I had one before. Anyway, you all. Let's talk about this beef with Foxy and Remy and Nicki and all of them. Let's get into it and other stuff. It's time for the bullshit. So let me get my music played. What is time for y'all? What is time for y'all? What is time for y'all?
Do you hear me?
Yo,
the bullshit. What is time for y'all?
Ow.
The bullshit.
Alright, listen. I'm on Industry on Blast. Do you all check that Instagram out, Industry on Blast? Well, they got a picture of August Alsina. Okay, he channels his inner Grace Jones. Grace Jones, the singer. I'm pretty sure you all are familiar with her. Well, August Alsina is he's a queen, honey. Okay, and they said that his Download Lover is Stray Songs, which is very believable. You know, I'm just so jealous. I wish I could be a part of that. Shout out to all you DL men that get to have all the other DL. Whatever. And did you all see that video of Trey Songz sex tape? Was that a man or a woman? By a show of comments. If you've seen the video, if you didn't see it, go Google it. It's Trey Songz fucking some man, or I don't know what it was. He was like, oh, bring that ass to me. By a show of comments. Do you think that was a man? Because you know Trey's bi. So was that a man or a female? I'm thinking a female because I don't see Trey recording having sex with a man, so it won't get out there because you know they all down low. But I don't know. By a show of comments, what do you think, that was a man or a woman? It looked good though. I didn't bust a nut to it yet. Like, I would just put my headphones in and just lay in my bed and just hear Trey. Because, like, his voice is very, like, ooh, bring that ass here. Very nice. Very motherfucking nice, bitch. Okay, we're gonna get the Foxy and Remy in a second. Just hold your, keep your panties on, bitch, okay? There's other stuff to talk about, okay? Did you all see that video with Chris Brown? Okay? Billboard is reporting that Chris Brown has anger and drug issues. Okay, they saying he is bipolar. Who isn't bipolar, bitch? I'm bipolar, but we all bipolar. Okay, Chris Brown posted some video because he wanted to respond to the in-depth expose published by Billboard magazine yesterday that alleged Chris is on a drug-fueled downward spiral. He's dancing with death. One current member of Brown's team tells the magazine, according to the insider, Chris often skips his medication for the bipolar 2 condition he was diagnosed with in 2004 and instead self-medicates with various drugs. Chris also said that he will kill Karrueche's boyfriend, her current boyfriend. He said, I will kill you. Okay, every time I see you, I will beat your ass. I don't know what's going on with Chris Brown. Like I told you, Chris Brown looked like shit. Watching them videos he's been posting, he's on some shit. On some shit. I don't want him no more. You all remember back in the days, I used to have the biggest crush on Chris. Chris looks like shit. Okay, I don't want him no more. Don't want that. That's crackhead dick, bitch. You know, I don't want no crackhead dick, bitch. Y'all can have that. Y'all can have that. Chris just got to get it together, honey. I don't understand how you get all this money and this fame and you blow it on some fucking drugs, bitch. Get your motherfucking life together, bitch. Get your motherfucking life together, Chris. Okay, before you end up dead. Okay? Do you all care for RuPaul's drag show? Drag Race. Shout out to all the real drag queens. Like, I'm not really a real drag queen. You know, I just put a little sun on my face. Shout out to all the drag queens who get done, darling. They get done. Okay, bitch, I just get done. I don't get done. Well, RuPaul's Drag Race Season 9 premieres on VH1 on March 24th at 8 p.m. He's no longer on Logo. Okay, they're saying that he wanted some more coins. He wanted some coins. So he's moving into VH1. That's going to be good. All the boys going to be in there, fellas. You all going to be in there. What is these faggots doing on VH1? Yes, bitch. All right, watch. And I'm also here for the Escape reunion. But I'm sorry. I saw that video with Escape and Big Tigger. Candy looked like she was over it. I don't know what it was. Candy just looked like she was not there for it. Yes, we gonna reunite. Next. She looked like Latavia and Latoya. Them two looked like they was more happy to be. Yes. Candy. And what's T.I. wife name? The other one. Candy and Tiny. Yeah, Tiny. They look like they was over it. I'm here for an Escape reunion. Who can I run to when I need love? I'm here for it. I love Escape. Escape got some good songs. You're My Little Secret. But I was just watching the video like, yo, okay, you won't want to talk about Foxy and Remy. I'm sorry. That's all been the topic of discussion this week. Remy, Nicki. That's it. No other celebrity news matters. We all like beef. Number one thing I love about this beef is that this is what real rapping is about. This is what rapping is about, bitch, okay? Oh, you little youngins, okay? Nicki Minaj is not a rapper, darling, okay? She's a pop star, okay? She's a pop. Remy, Foxy, Kim, these are rappers. Rod Digger, these are female MCs, okay? As far as Nicki Minaj go, I just feel like if you wasn't, like I said in the beginning of my video, if you wasn't going to acknowledge Remy, you was not supposed to put nothing up. The fact that you put up her record sales and you put all this, you know, stuff up, that shows that you see what's going on. I'm pretty sure you know what's going on, but you just want to act like you don't know. Now you want to really act like you don't know. You too busy in them doing them fashion shows and in Paris. Darling, you are getting slaughtered out here. That Remy Ma track murdered you. There's nothing you can say, nothing. So her best bet is to stay quiet. But I was also thinking, what is she going to gain by responding to Remy? Yes, it's a hip hop beef. This is what the hip hop artists do. They go back and forth. But in all actuality, Nicki Minaj is a huge star. Why would she respond to Remy? This is going to benefit Remy. It's not going to help Nicki. So I'm like, okay, ignore her, but you should never said nothing from the start, okay? You should just ignored her from the start, bitch. Yes, Nicki. Now, on this song that Remy put out, she said something about Foxy. What'd she say? She said, I know you talking to that deaf bitch about me. That's why she, you know, I feel sorry for deaf people, but I don't feel sorry when you go deaf from getting gonorrhea. So Remy is basically saying Foxy got untreated gonorrhea, which is a disease. It was never treated, so that made Foxy deaf. Yes, I mean, not yes, like, yes, that's true, but that can cause, like, if you don't treat your STDs, there's side effects, and one of the side effects, I guess, gonorrhea is to get you deaf. So anyway, Foxy has responded to Remy, and everyone's like, why is she responding? Da, da, da. Bitch, because Remy called her out. If this is between Nicki and Remy, bitch, why are you mentioning my name for? Why are you mentioning my deafness? Why are you mentioning my gonorrhea? Why, bitch? Now I'm coming for you. So I was so amped up, like, yes, Foxy. Then I heard the track. I was like, oh, wow, Foxy. Here's the track. I'm gonna let you all hear it, but I mean, it's okay, but here it is.
So the shit about me to a deafness.
Yo, Fox, murder that pussy cunt. All of some blood clot. Okay. Yo, Fox, murder that blood clot.
Fuck, will I be killing this bitch?
The break's over, nigga.
Got a little shine, okay. Think Mona, I heard your little rhymes, okay. Brooklyn, I'm on my 9-6 shit. Got the DNA of Hova and Nick my bitch. But bitch, I'm saying I'm on the concourse lane. Bitch, I'm not playing. When we was on the island, Rim was a PC shook. She was never tough, she was never wailing. The blood clot this. Y'all better tell us, boom, bitch. Fox, born a shot. Dusty ass broad, dig some sweet. She get the part to a hot 97 in the street. Still in that dirty ass TS piece. And Pat, fuck that dirty ass BX beast. I'm a motherfucking BK savage. Murr. And I heard about that bitch miscarriage. Brooklyn, I'm a killer. The Garden Reggie Miller. The Barclays floor seat, all black chinchilla.
Yo, Fox, murder that pussy clod.
Murder that pussy clod, man. Murder that pussy. So that's the snippet, and that's probably all we get, because you know Foxy is legendary for these snippets. Hopefully she released the full version. Like, I would like to hear the rest of the song. My thought on this is, Foxy, what was the point of you mentioning the miscarriage? I heard about your little miscarriage. Remy put it out there. Everyone heard about the miscarriage. But the thing is, Fox, in 2003, you had an interview on a radio, WBLS, with Wendy Williams. You had a miscarriage. You had a miscarriage. So how are you going to diss her for having a miscarriage? And you had it like that. Foxy. That wasn't a good look. The song. I'm hearing that Remy is getting some battle rapper. I don't know the girl's name, but she has some battle rapper that's gonna write a diss towards Foxy. I don't know if she's gonna respond to Foxy. I don't know. What do you all think about that track? I'm glad to see Foxy back. You know, congrats on the baby, if you really had a baby. I just feel like you were supposed to come harder than this. I gotta keep it real. That's whack. This is whack. I'm sorry. I don't know if this is the flow. The flow is good. Foxy still got that flow. The beat is hard. It's just, I don't know. I don't know. What do you all think? Am I wrong? Like, y'all know I love Foxy. I love Remy. And I wish Foxy was on Remy's side in this situation. I hate that she's Team Nicki. I wish she was on the team of Remy and Foxy, because Nicki, not too many people like her. It's just something I don't like. And I hate to see that Foxy's on Team Nicki when she should be on Remy. The real bitches, you on this. So I don't know, but what do you all think? And as far as Remy go, I think Remy at this point, you need to just stop it. You put out the first diss track, which was murder, and then you try to come back with another track. I don't know what was the point of that. A lot of people said that was whack. I thought it was all right, you know, but it was not like the first track. I think this is, stop. You stop it. You overdoing it now, bitch. Okay, at this point, you fighting with a dead person. You said you killed her. All right, now you had her funeral today on Wendy. Might I add, Remy was so funny on Wendy Williams today. Did you all see Remy on Wendy? Hilarious, fat joke. It was a good show today, and it was a funeral for Nicki Minaj. Remy's very entertaining. But I think after this, I don't want to hear if that's it. If you're gonna do another diss track, go at Foxy, okay? Because she wants to fight. Okay? But Nicki is clearly ignoring you at this point. I don't know if she's scared, you know, but it's a rap battle. You were supposed to respond back to Remy. I know she probably have it in her, you know, but I guess at this point she's like, oh my God, I got Remy Ma named as huge so far. What have I done? Like, a lot of people, so many white people know who Remy Ma is right now because of you, Nicki, because of that diss. So a lot of people know who she is. And I don't think Nicki like that because Nicki probably wants to be the only female rapper. Yeah. But Remy, I'm happy because this brought life back to female rap. You got Foxy, Rip, like, oh, I love this. I'm pretty sure Little Kim Poppy put her two cents in. You know she like attention too. So I'm pretty sure she might have something. Because Foxy just dissed her in there. When she said that whole Hot 97 too. You know when that whole shootout happened at Hot 97. I don't know what you hoes think. Let me know. You know. I'm about to go to break. And speaking of Remy Ma and Hot 97. We're going to go to break. But I want you all to listen to this video. This is Remy Ma shouting out to me. She was on a Miss Jones show. I forget what the conversation was about, but I don't know. Remy was late. I think I said she probably come up there smelling like weed. I don't know what it was, but this was back in the days. This is Remy Ma just shouting me out, saying, shout out to Bamba, da da da, whatever, whatever. So, and this is also the Wendy movie and all that, you know, back in the back. So we'll be back. I have an email for you hoes from Trina, plus the loving it or come again is from Nashima Williams. Do you know who that is? That's Meek Mill's sister. And she's going at Remy and Nicki. So you all gotta stay here for that. So a mess. So we'll be back. This is the Diction Show, and I love you for. Oh, wait, we're not finished yet. I'm so horny. All right, we'll be right back. Wonka Wonka L.
No more.
No other Remy Ma. I'm sorry.
Like, no, we got like this. We got three bitches on the.
That's a bimbo. I don't know how he always get thrown. How does that happen?
You heard bimbo.
He's the worst. Every time I'm here, he gets through. You know, I be answering the phones like, how does he get through every time?
He's trying to audition for Wendy's movie, but they blew up the spot on the movie that she was charging $20 just to audition.
If it's not legal, why not?
My thing is this. If you want to charge, bitch, hit them up. $50 just for my time. And I'm calling it an application fee.
Exactly.
Holla not at your girl. Yeah, not no $20. That's just very...
You got to make sure it's non-refundable.
Exactly.
Very little underneath it.
My time is very precious. So,
I don't care.
That's crazy.
Get that money. So everybody got to hustle.
Remy's here, y'all.
So I'm back, bitch. Y'all enjoying the show today? I've been in a real festive mood, darling. Real happy, darling. Alright. Yes, darling. Yes, Miss Peaches. Miss motherfucking Peaches. Alright. When you gonna bring me my cigarettes, bitch? Miss motherfucking Peaches. I need my new ports, bitch. I need my motherfucking new ports. Alright. And bring my bottle of motherfucking Absolute, bitch, when I fucking call it. My fucking bottle of Absolute. The $25.99 motherfucking bottle, bitch. Mixed with some cranberry and some motherfucking orange juice. Miss motherfucking Peaches. You got that motherfucking right, bitch. You know what the fuck I said. Who am I talking to? I don't know who the fuck I'm talking to, bitch. She don't know. She ain't gotta know. You ain't gotta know either, darling. Okay? Just bring me my fucking Newports. You don't need Newports. I don't smoke. I just want my Newports. The fuck am I talking about? Am I the only one that sniff my slippers? My feet don't stick. I just have a way of sniffing my slippers. Do you sniff your panties and your boxes when you about to get in your shower? Do you ever rub your balls and smell them? You know we do a lot of nasty shit, but little do we know we all do it. I love sniffing my slippers. I don't know what it is. How many more months until the summer? I can't take no more of this fucking cold. I cannot. I hate being cold. I like to be naked. I like being. I can't take this cold. All right, listen, you guys. Let me stop playing. Let me tell you what I just did. I'm a little upset because I just recorded this segment of the show but this fucking camera fucked up. So I have to re-record this segment. And I forgot what everything I said in the last segment. So I'm a little upset, but I'm gonna do it again because I want to get the show done. Yes, I just recorded this Hey Bimbo Girl, and the camera fucked up. This is why I need to buy me a new camera. So make some donations so I could get me a new fucking camera, bitch. So upset. I don't know what I said. I said some good shit. Now I gotta redo it. I hope this doesn't mess up. Anyway, if you need some advice, you got a situation going on in your life, email me. It's heybimbogirl. heybimbogirl@gmail.com. And I will get your email on this show's all in. Yes, I will. Alright. heybimbogirl@gmail.com. If you need advice, you got a little situation, you want my little advice, hit me up. Real quick, Martel West. Hey Martel West. You sent me the videos of you in drag. The only problem is that it has music attached to it. So I don't think I'm going to be able to show the videos. Because I know one you're doing, Whitney Houston. You look very fabulous, darling. Very fabulous. But you had one with Whitney Houston. And can you try to send me one without like a popular song? Like a song that's not popular. Like I seen your K-Michelle one. I'm going to try to get you up. I don't know. Maybe next week. I don't care. Because you know, I don't care of all that copyright stuff. Just, you know, when I have stuff in my video that I'm not supposed to have, like music and stuff, they show ads. So just click the ad out. So maybe I'll show you a video next week. It's a drag queen, one of my supporters, Martel West. Fabulous. I'll get your video up next week. This week, the Loving It or Come Again, I have to show Nashima Williams. Y'all know who Nashima Williams is? Well, that is Meek Mill's sister. She looked just like Meek Mill's. And she's going at Remy and Nicki. And it's a hot mess. So I'll show her in a second. But I just want to get to this email because I'm a little upset, bitch, because I recorded this already. I have to do it again. So I don't know what I said before. So I'm going to try to get through this email again. All right, you guys. I'm a little highly upset. This is from Trina. She said, "Hey, Bimbo, I'm 25 and recently me and my ex got back together and broke up again. I miss him, but he offers me nothing. He is self-employed, aka no job. Stay." I just read all this. I give you a good answer, and I gotta read this shit again. This fucking computer. Alright, I'm sorry, Trina. Because I just read this, and the video didn't record. Something happened. I'm doing this again. I'm trying to show some type of, you know, because I'm mad I'd have to do this again. Anyway, he is self-employed, aka no job. He stays with his mom, has a small dick. Never wanted to go out with me during the day and will say negative things about my weight. I feel like I was his big girl secret, but despite it all, I loved him. I think it's because, one, I'm a big girl, so yes, I have a lot of insecurities, and I never thought about someone sexy as him, and hunty, he is fine. So where's the pictures, bitch? Send me some pictures of him. Someone as fine as him will want me. Two, he's my first love. Three, I'm afraid that no one will love me again because of my size. My question is, what's the best way to get over a breakup with your first love? I'm constantly checking his FB, Instagram, and Twitter, which he blocked me from, and he seems to be happy, but I'm not. What do I do? He knows all he has to do is make one call and I'm his. How do I stop this cycle and find happiness? Give it to me straight, boo. All tea or shade. Love you, Bimbo. You're forever my BFF in my head. Wonka wonka am. Trina. Well, my last video that I did something. I think I had took a cup of water. I said, let me drink my water first. Trina, the best way to get over this, I've learned. First of all, I don't know why y'all do these relationships. I don't do relationships. I don't do these relationships. You all do these relationships. Use a meatball. Relationships are for meatballs. Single life is the best motherfucking life. But since you asking me, the best way I've learned to get over a relationship is to get under another man or 20 other men. That's how you get your mind off one man. You get under the next man. Why do you all waste your time with these men that's no fucking good, bitch? The way to get your mind off one man is to get under another one. I mean, I don't do relationships, but you all know I've been stressing this basketball player. We wasn't in a relationship, but we met up a lot of times. So I was getting used to him and I was starting to believe it was a relationship. And then he just completely cut me off. And I was hurt. I was hurt for a little while because I got used to this sexy, tall, light skin, nice bubble butt, big dick, sexy in the face. Oh, I got used to him. And he just dissed me. Like, he stopped hitting me up. Talking about I have an attitude. I don't know what he said. I don't know. But my way of getting over that was to get under other men. That's the best thing. And then you said, why did I let these men with no fucking jobs? He lived with his fucking mother. Bitch, he don't have nothing going on in his motherfucking life. Why are you stressed out all this over this fucking man? Why, bitch? Okay, yes, you a big girl. And that's another thing I hate is that you big girls, you get down. You let these men put you down as if you're nothing. So what, you're fat, bitch? There's someone out there who's going to want you. Believe it or not. There's going to be a dude out there who's going to be proud to say that you his girl. Be proud to take you out. Be proud to love you. Stop letting these no good, small dick motherfuckers. So what, he look good, bitch? It don't matter. You deserve better than this, okay? I know this, big girls be the happiest, sweetest girls in this world. They are so nice and sweet and cool motherfuckers. And you let these motherfucking men tear you down because you're big. So the fuck what, bitch? Are you happy with your weight? If you're not happy with your weight, the way to take your mind off, get in the gym. Do something that makes you happy. Do something that will get your mind off this dude. Like, I'll be honest with you all. There was a person I used to always, like, every day I'll check their Facebook. Because you know some people, we ain't friends with them, but we'd like to, like, stalk them and look up their Facebook. Like, I'm not going to tell you who it is. I'm not going to tell you if it was a man, female. Nope. Just know I used to always stalk this person page every day. And I used to be so depressed, like, oh, they living a life. And come to find out, this person was jealous of me. And here I go every day looking at this person page, thinking they living a life. And this same person, I'm like, what the fuck you jealous of me for? You don't want living a life. But I say, all I have to say is that I had to stop looking at this person page every day. Because it was making me, like, I would look at this person page and then be depressed because this person is living a life. And I'm like, you're only hurting yourself when you continue to do something that you know is going to hurt you. You know what I mean? Like, Trina, you looking at this dude page, stop doing it, bitch. This man don't give a fuck. He has a small fucking dick. Live with his mother. What the fuck you want with a man like that? The fuck do you want, okay? Oh, and then I know you're gonna go back. If he calls you, I know for a fact that you probably, your fat ass gonna run back to his, well, bitch, this is what you do. If you miss the dick, that's what you need to miss the dick, okay? After, if you see him, fuck him and keep it the fuck moving. Do not ask him how's his mother doing. Do not ask if he found the job. Do not ask him to know, bitch. At this point, this man don't give two, he blocks you. A person block you, that means they don't give two fucks about you. Why are you wasting your motherfucking time? There's other motherfuckers out there. You need to get your mind off this one motherfucker. He don't give two fucks about you, bitch. You fat bitch, get in the gym, okay? Lose. Are you happy with your weight? Because some big girls are happy with their weight. If you're not happy with your weight, lose the weight. It did come off quick. But you have to move. The only way to move on from this dude is to move the fuck on. You know I don't do relationships, so I don't know the best advice. But the only guy I can tell you from someone, if I was in your shoes and this dude don't give... It's kind of hard doing to do it. It's easier said than done. But the more you start to do something, the easier it get. So the less you look at this dude page, the more he's going to get out your mind. The less you think about him, the more you have to move on, darling. If you have to, even though I hate to say it, create a social media account, they ain't no better than it, but start meeting some other dudes. You know, confidence goes a long way. You could be a big girl, because I've seen some big girls who their confidence are high. And then I see these little skinny bitches who are pretty. Oh, I'm so ugly. Men are not attracted to that. They're not attracted to that. You know? So, it's all in your confidence. Okay? You can always lose the weight. But you need to just move on, darling. You really need to move on and not sit around letting some no good small dick motherfucker bring you down, bitch. Okay? So, keep your head high and just keep on moving. Don't stop. All right, you hoes, I got to go. Remember, if you want to email me, my email is heybimbogirl@gmail.com. And I love you all. I love you. I do. Remember to subscribe to my channel. Share this video on your Facebook, your Twitter. Add me on Facebook and Instagram and all that good shit. And all that. Okay? It's late. Alright, I'm about to take this wig off, put my other wig on, and make it do what it do. Alright, I love you all. Don't forget to donate a little something to the GoFundMe page, bitch, okay? But before we go, the Love In It or Come Again, like I told you, is from Meek Mill's sister. His sister name is Nashima Williams, and she going at Remy and Nicki. It's a hot mess, so check it out. Let me know what you think, and I will see you hoes on the next show. Wonka Wonka Am. SMG Audio.
None of these bitches, I don't know fucking loyalty to either one of these bitches. I don't remember getting a dime from either one of these bitches, so I'll happily put the nine on either one of these bitches. I do the shit cause it's forbidden, I'm living it, plus I live it. Anyone could get it, I'm with it, never no fucking limit. I don't sneak this, that's the difference. Cause Remy been ripping Nicki, she just won't admit it. Now keep it real, Remy, we all know you baited the bitch, you shaded the bitch and waited on the hoe to say something slick, you hated.